Welcome to ASK Tutorials. This is a C programming series and we are learning C structures. How the structures are used in a C programming, we will see in this video. If you are not seen our previous videos, then watch it. Link is given into the description box. Now let's get start with the video. First we will see what is a structure. It is a user-defined data type. By using structure, we can define data type which holds more than one element of a different types. In array, we can define the same data types, but in a structure, we can define the different types of data types. C structure is a collection of different data types which are grouped together, and each element in a C structure is called a member. Structures are used to represent a record. Let's see an example of a library here. Suppose you want to keep a track of your books in a library, you might want to track the following attributes about each book here. Then you should keep the record of a title, author, subject, book ID. This should you have to keep the record for the library. Defining a structure. How the structure is defined? To define a structure, you must use the struct statement here. Structure can be defined by using a struct keyword. The struct statement defines a new data type with more than one member. The format of the struct statement is as follow. First, we define the struct with a structure tag, then we open a curly bracket. Inside that you can define a member definition there, then closed the curly bracket. After closing a curly bracket, you should give a semicolon there. This is a format of defining a structure. Now we will see an example of defining structure. Let's take example of a book. Here we gave a structure name as a books here. Then inside a curly bracket we define the character arrays. Three arrays we declared here. Then we declared the integer book ID is a variable. Then we closed the curly bracket. Then we given a written there book and a semicolon. So this example can be used in a while we are keeping a record of a library. Now we will see accessing a structure members. To access any member of a structure, we use the member access pointer which comes with a dot. The member access pointer is coded as a period between the structure variable name and the structure member that we wish to access. You would use the keyword struct to define a variables of a structure type. The following example shows how to use a structure in a program. We will see here how to use a structure in a program. First, we declared the two preprocessor commands here. First one is a stdio.h and second one is a string.h. Then we declared the defined here our struct. It's a structure we defined here. Struct books is a name. Then inside that we given a three character arrays and a integer variable book ID. And after a closing curly bracket we gave a semicolon there. Then we declared a main function. Inside a main function we declare here declare the book one of a type book. For a struct book we declared the book one. Then now we will give a specification for a book one by using a string copy function. String copy function we used here for defining for taking a book title here. Then we used the, again we used a string copy function for author, book author. For a subject, again we used the string copy function here. Then book 1 dot book id is given there with a number. Then after specifying the book 1 information, we have to display the book 1 information, so we have to give a printf statement for title, author, subject and a book id. Here in a printf statement we will print the book 1 title, author, subject and a book id. When we will execute this program, we will get output like this here. The book title is a expert in a C programming, book author is a Peter Van, and the subject is a C programming, and book ID is a 6495407. It will display like this output. This is how we learned the structure, how the structure is used in a C programming. In a structure, we used the character types array and a integer variable. So the structure will holds the different type of a data types. Thank you for watching the video.